I'm going to talk over a video that I just recorded in which I spin up a storefront that automatically sells websites in 26 minutes. So when you sign up to WPCS, you get this storefront. It has all the plugins and the modifications and the everything you need in order to start spinning sites and create subscriptions with different functionalities that your users can use. So you can actually centrally manage and update all your sites in such a way that you only have to dedicate a few minutes per month at this. So you can start a WaaS out of the box. In just a few minutes, I'm going to show you how that works. So the first thing you need to do if you get on the platform is create a storefront. So that's the first option you go through. And then the next thing you're going to do is you're going to give your storefront a name. So I actually went for a name that was a bit too long. So you might want to think about a bit of a shorter name. So the next decision we need to make is where our data center is going to be. So the storefront needs to be in a place. And since I'm in the Netherlands, Ireland's going to be pretty close. So right now we're spinning up a version, and then this version has a tenant immediately, and this is the tenant that houses your storefront. So tenants are websites. You control them through versions. In the tenant, you can actually set up the storefront, and that's what we're going to do right now. So every tenant overview has a magic login, which will bring you to the WP admin immediately, and then we're going to go and have a look at the plugins real quickly, because what we have here is subscriptions for WooCommerce, the WaaS host, which is a plugin that we've built for you that connects to the platform. We've got WooCommerce, and because we need to get paid, we have WooCommerce Stripe Gateway. So right now, we're just gonna run through the setup process of WooCommerce. It's just gonna be very straightforward, and we don't wanna spend too much time on that, so I'm just gonna, you know, fast forward this a little bit. So like I said, I'm in the Netherlands. Just select the Netherlands or whatever city you're in, whatever country you're in. We're just gonna go through the setup process, create subscriptions, and then we're going to be setting up subscriptions for WooCommerce. So the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go to the WP Swings tab, which is going to launch subscription for WooCommerce. We're going to set up the plugin. We're just gonna keep it simple right now. And in this process, we're creating a product already. So the moment we've set that up, we're gonna go back to the platform, to WPCS, and we're gonna spin up a new application. So the application that we're going to spin up right now is actually the application in which our customers are going to be. So this is the actual product that we're going to sell. And in this case, we're going to launch the application from scratch. But like I said, you can import any site that you've built in the past that you think works well to a broader audience. So it could be a site in which you specialize towards a certain use case. It could be a site that is very much catered towards a certain audience. It could be a site that has a specific functionality that you're really good at, like WooCommerce or LMS or communities, for example. You can take that site, import it into WPCS, and just run with it. It works like a SaaS out of the box. You don't have to do anything else. But right now, for the sake of this tutorial, we're gonna keep it simple, so we're gonna launch it from scratch. So like before, we need to select the database in which, or rather the data center in which our storefront or application is going to be. And then, like I mentioned earlier, every version is the control center for all of your sites. So all the sites share the same code base, which means that they all have the same plugins, the same language files, the same theme files. Your customers can control the database. So they can build the pages, write the copy, upload media files. You can do that for them as their template. And then afterwards, this is what they control. But you are in full control of the code, which includes the version of WordPress and the version of PHP. So that's what we're going to choose right now as we spin up the version. So right now we're spinning up the version, we're gonna go to the version, and then we're gonna open up the version editor. So the version editor is the control center for all of your sites, right? So this is where you install all the features. So you're gonna install functionality, plugins, theme files. In this case, we're gonna start with the WaaS client. This is a free plugin that we've built for you that controls the products. This is how you can actually create the products that your customers are getting. So the way we do that is by creating roles, which I'm gonna show you in a minute. But for now, we're gonna install WooCommerce because we're just gonna imagine that we're gonna launch a Shopify alternative, right? So we're actually gonna build out a fully fledged WooCommerce site. Not right now, but you know, imaginative. And obviously you need to do that with WooCommerce. So we're going to install the plugin WooCommerce and then we're gonna build out that application. So installing WooCommerce right now, and then we're gonna go to the tenant settings. So the moment we have the tenant settings, we can actually start creating the roles. So every site that you spin up, every plan that you are going to sell is connected to a role. And the role decides the functionality that your customers are going to get. And by functionality, I mean the plugins and themes that are available to them. So this is how you can actually unlock functionality to them, but also withhold functionality from them. And you can upsell that functionality automatically by creating roles. And then from the dashboard that they get after they make a purchase in your storefront, they can upsell themselves. So right now we're gonna launch a role. This is the e-commerce role, as it were. And just to make it clear how these roles work, I'm going to create a new role by installing another plugin. So the plugin I'm going to go for is just Jetpack right now. It really doesn't matter what you use. It's just to clarify that you can actually create multiple roles. So right now I'm also creating the Jetpack role, and this is going to include Jetpack and WooCommerce. So plan number one is just WooCommerce, plan number two, Jetpack and WooCommerce. And so right now I have two plans that I can also sell for more or less. And then the moment I have that functionality in my version, I'm gonna go back to the version overview and deploy a snapshot. Snapshots are important because you use a snapshot to spin up a site, but the moment you have tenants, so sites in your version, you can update your sites by creating a snapshot. So every time you deploy a snapshot and you've done something new in your version, you're automatically sending those changes to all of your sites. Code changes, I mean. So the database is separate because you don't wanna overwrite anything your customers have done. So deploying a snapshot right now, I'm just gonna call it roles, but normally you wouldn't be very specific with the snapshots you're creating, so you can always see exactly what's happening in that snapshot. And now we're gonna create an API key. So the API key is really just a way to connect the storefront to the application. So the moment we've connected the API key to the storefront knows where to spin up sites and what sites to spin up. So really it's that simple, right? So all you need to do, set up the plugins, create roles, create an API key, connect it to the storefront, and then you're ready to go. Because right now we're creating a product. So the moment we're making a product, you're going to go for a simple product with a subscription, and then you're gonna click on the WPCS button, which we're gonna do right now. And then it will show in the vertical menu a new tab. Before we do that, we're gonna set the price for $10 right now, which is totally fine. But I wanna clarify that you can make this price whatever you want it to be. So the more value is in the product that your customers are getting, the higher your price can be. This price can range from $50 per month to $5,000 per month, depending on the SaaS that you're creating. So right now, when we go back to the WPCS overview, we're refreshing the roles, which will then show you the actual roles that we've created and which we can connect to a WooCommerce product. So the moment we have connected that, we're going to set up Stripe Gateway because obviously we want to get paid. And the moment we've done that, we're done. We didn't do much in terms of designing the storefront, which is not what this is about. It's just a WooCommerce store. You can customize it however you like. You're going to check out, which is also not very fancy, but that doesn't matter because in just a few seconds, we have a new site. So I want to pause right here because you need to set a website name. Every customer that you get gives it a website name. And what the website name is the moment you've created a storefront and you've connected it to a domain, say WPCS.io, I buy a site and I'm going to get that site as a subdomain under the main domain. So my name is Roger. So in this case, if the main domain is WPCS.io, the site I'm going to get is roger.wpcs.io, which means this entire platform is white labeled out of the box. And then later on, I'm going to show you that your customers can actually set their own domain name. So right now we spin up a new site and we have the order received. So before I dive into that subscription overview, I'm just going to spin up a new site so that later on I can show you how you can centrally update those two sites. So now we're going to look at the subscription overview. This is the My Account page for your customers. So you have the website status, they got everything they want, and they can even log in with a magic login. So the moment the site is ready with provisioning, they can log in their own storefront overview, and they don't have to remember the password. That's the beauty of it. They can just go ahead and do whatever. So right now, I spun up two sites in just a few seconds. It's really that fast. You go to the WP plugin overview just to show you that they have the same plugins. Going to go back to the version overview, click on the version editor and installing a new plugin. Because that's how you can actually centrally manage all your sites as if it's only one. So right now we're gonna add a new plugin, it can be anything. I'm going to do Akismet, deploy a snapshot, and now this snapshot is going to centrally send over all the code changes to the sites that I have currently. And so that obviously also introduces a bit of a risk because if I'm sending over new functionality to my production sites instantly, that may break some or more of your sites. And if it's just a few, it may not be a big problem, but if it's thousands or hundreds, it may be a big problem because you might, you know, create an error on tens or dozens or hundreds of sites at the same time. So what we've done is we've created a versioning system. So you can actually, instead of creating a snapshot in a version that has tenant sites, you can create a new version, and this version is completely separate. It is a clone of the old version, so you can iterate on your product. You can just go off and improve whatever you have right now, but it's separate, it's isolated. And so this is also a moment where you can decide to update or upgrade the version of WordPress. So I always like to call my versions, you know, progressively, V1, V2, so on. So we're launching a clone of a version, which is now separate. As you can see, it does not have any tenants inside, which is where I can build out my new functionality. And when I'm done, I can move over my tenants. So I can move over my sites from one version to the other. And this is how you have this safe deployment cycle. And if you break something, you can roll back. You can just move your tenants back to the old version. And this is how they, how you undo any of the errors that you might have created, which, you know, is a very safe and predictable way of managing thousands of sites at the same time. And it introduces SaaS methodology to your sites, to your agency, in a way that you can productize any site and turn it into an actual SaaS application. That is the beauty of the platform. We have a storefront that works out of the box. It has everything included that you need in order to run your sites and create this fluid MRR generating site provisioning tool. You have a way to centrally manage all your sites if it's only one. And because it's completely containerized cloud platform, you don't have to worry about servers. It will do all the work for you. All the sites can handle any type of traffic. It will scale up and down according to the site traffic that your customers get. That's it, you guys. If you're looking to launch this storefront for free, sign up for WPCS.io and get started right away. If you're looking to dive deeper into the different functionalities, the tenant snapshots, different billing features, the way you switch domains, it's all on the website. If you want to know how the platform works, just get started or watch any of the other videos that we've made. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see your success on the platform soon.